His last fight, 21 seconds. When are you fighting next?
September 14th on the Mayweather Canelo court.
Clemens, what do you think about Tabiti?
What I think about Tabiti?
Yeah.
Did I mention that he hit hard?
Have you sparred him?
Nah, we ain't work. I ain't got a spar.
How do you know?
Hear it from the outside of the ring.
Almost
really?
Almost two days.
Why do people, originally the family's from Nigeria?
Yeah.
Why do Nigerians hit so hard?
Get strong. I guess it's in the blood.
That's it. A nation of warriors.
Yeah.
So, and everybody in the gym, what makes him unique? Why did they make him join TNT? Like, what was it about him?
Not only do he hit hard, but he fast. He got speed. He got great movement. He can box and he can punch. And anybody on the other side of them, anybody on the other side of them 10-ounce gloves, I feel sorry for him.
You seen his first opponent, right? You seen what happened?
Yeah.
Seconds.
Can I say something? I blinked and it was over.
It was over.
So,
just like that.
What do you think about Will?
He's a great fighter, man. You know what I'm saying? He's up and coming. He's fast. So, you know, I'm looking forward to seeing him in the future, too.
Have you seen him spar Floyd?
Yeah.
What do you think about that? That's pretty exciting.
Yeah, hard, yeah.
Excellent spar. His nickname is 21.
Why?
21 minutes straight.
I never seen anybody go that long with Floyd.
21 straight minutes sparring? Dude, I got in the ring with James Toney. After a minute 30, I was tired. It's hard.
Yeah, it's definitely hard, man.
That's what they call it, hard work and dedication.
How did you survive 21 minutes with Floyd Mayweather?
So, I got a God-given talent. It's not necessarily survive because I did work, you know. And he's great at the craft. He's great at our craft and everything. But I also got a God-given talent. And I was able to, you know, do some things to hold me over. And down the line, of course, the championship rounds, things got really started landing more. But at the same time, I didn't give up. I was going. So everything that was said afterwards as far as, like, you know, some people say I got beat up. You really got to, I wish you was just there.
Dude, they need to get in there for 21 seconds, not 21 minutes.
Yeah.
It's easy to start
against the best in the world. So
exactly.
What do you expect, you know what I mean?
Hey, got to ask you this, though.
No problem.
You're from Ohio.
Yeah.
Where are you from originally?
Chicago.
Midwest in the building.
The Midwest in the building.
Hey, Newark, New Jersey, baby. Brick City, baby.
So tell me this. Chicago, who's big in the boxing scene besides yourself now?
Chicago,
Nate Jones used to be.
Yeah, Nate Jones used to be. I don't really know too much about that.
Okay, in Ohio, we have a lot of fights from Adrian Broner to yourself.
You know, I was one
Mickey
of his primary sparring partners before.
But Adrian, I can see that.
Yeah.
You picked up some of your swag from him, and he picked it up from you.
He's younger, you know, but he got great talent. He's always been like a younger brother to me, you know. He got great talent. He worked hard also. His work ethnicity is, his work ethic is just wonderful, just great.
Young brothers from Ohio.
I can't see. But if he fights Marcos Maidana November 9th, what do you think of that fight?
As long as he go in there with the right head, like, he should have stopped Pauly. If he would have been jabbing more and going to the body, you know, he would have stopped Pauly, but he was just on trying to hurt him. So as long as he go in there as him and come in with the right level head and everything, he gonna stop Maidana. But he gotta be careful because Maidana's a dangerous fighter.
What do you think? Broner, Malignaggi?
You said Malignaggi.
Sorry. Broner, Maidana.
Yeah, Maidana. I say Broner, but only Broner if he stay busy. If he just wait, you know, I don't know.
Why did you guys choose boxing? It's such a tough sport. You could have played any other sport and, you know, it's easier to make it. It's so tough in boxing.
Yeah, it's tough, but I just started getting good at it. It's just something that happened in an accident, you know. I fell in love with it.
And what's the nickname?
I don't have a nickname yet.
His nickname hit hard.
Why did you choose boxing?
I chose boxing. I kind of fell into it. I was taken to a gym, and I wanted to spar, and I ended up sparring with one of the fighters that was young. I ended up sparring with one of the fighters that had a lot of fights, and I beat him up. He said, I beat him. And I had a mouthpiece and everything. He said, I beat him. This was like a little bit after the
Tyson Holyfield.
Yeah. He said, I beat him, so he was crying. And I fell in love with it. I've been good, talented ever since then. Even without me working hard, my talent still helped me to be able to dominate whoever I get in the ring.
There you have it. Now, on a serious note, if I got grills like that and then my interviews, would it work for me or will people think like, nah?
They might think you're a dope boy like they think I'm a dope boy.
Hey, listen.
He doing more than taking videos.
If that's your career by choice?
He a rich brother. He got gold in his mouth.
I'm broke. Money, that's why he's with the money.
So broke I can't pay attention.
There you have it. Stay tuned. That's my mama jokes right there. EsNewsReport.com. I'm Melissa back reporting. Like, you know, your mama's so slow it takes her 2 hours to 60 minutes. Your mama's so old when Moses split the Red Sea, she was on the other side fishing. Your mama's so mean, Al Qaeda wouldn't recruit her. Your mama's so small, you can see her feet on her driver license photo. Your mama's so small, she plays basketball with the Cocoa Puff.
Uh-huh.
And your mama's so dumb, she thinks Taco Bell is a Mexican phone company.
You're silly, bro. You're silly.